Recently, I did a video on remnant cholesterol. It was supposed to be a definition, meaning, and explanation, but I kept it to 90 seconds. So really all you got was sort of a definition. Remnant cholesterol is the cholesterol that includes all of the triglycerides. So we're going to talk about that and give a little bit deeper discussion, because remnant cholesterol has been getting bad rap recently, and I think it may be deserved. Coming up. So, okay, let's take a look at remnant cholesterol. You just take your, to find out what your remnant cholesterol is, you take your HDL and your LDL, and you take that out of your total cholesterol. Then you count everything else. IDL, which is, well, let's go back and remember the names. HDL is high density lipoprotein. LDL is low density lipoprotein. IDL, intermediate density lipoprotein. VLDL, very low density lipoprotein. And chylomicrons, which are, again, all of these big ones have, these big fluffy ones have a lot more triglyceride in them. When you look at the density of these lipoproteins, you're looking at ApoA and ApoB. ApoA is in the HDLs, the high density lipoproteins. And what is ApoA and ApoB? Apo just means the protein section. So the protein that holds these tiny fat globules or oil globules together is the apoprotein. For HDL, you have one protein, and it's called ApoA. For LDL, VLDL, IDL, chylomicrons, you tend to get ApoB. And by the way, LP little a is a variation of this ApoB. It's a variation of LDL. So again, back to this point. If you want to calculate your remnant cholesterol, just calculate those by taking your total cholesterol and subtracting your HDL and LDL. Now, wait a minute, real quick. Density lipoproteins, what is this all about? Just a reminder, if you put oil in water, it doesn't mix, right? Those globules would form what we call an embolus, a big ball, if we had that in our bloodstream. And in fact, that happens when you get major trauma, like multiple broken bones, and even some surgery. That's called a fat embolism, and it can kill you. So how does the body keep that from happening? Proteins, ApoA and ApoB. So the body puts this ApoA and ApoB in our GI, gastrointestinal and blood system, and it takes these masses of fats and oils and takes them into microscopic particles that will not cause an embolism. So, just a brief mention from Brad and Amy. This is some of Brad Bale's old work. He had a family member do some cartoons for him. But that's a side issue. Pardon the digression. Here's the point. As Brad's saying here, LDL, why do I get all the attention? Very, very good point. LP little a or lipo A is a big, big deal. A mass murderer, many people would call it. But these other ones are even bigger issues, maybe. Remnant cholesterol, VLDL, IDL, and triglycerides. So let's go back. And again, that's what we're looking at. VLDL cholesterol test, basically remnant cholesterol. If you want to hear it from somebody else, just go to Wikipedia. It's very simple. It's always there. Now, here's one of the key things to remember about remnant cholesterol. This is a graph showing BMI versus fraction of remnant cholesterols. And what you see here is there's a good linear pattern, meaning the heavier you are, the more likely you are to have higher remnant cholesterol. So here's a remnant cholesterol down less than 19, maybe 15 for somebody with BMI in the 18 to 19 range, this black one, excuse me. The red one is a BMI greater than 30, and they've got remnant cholesterol's way over 19. So obesity is one thing for sure. But here's the bigger issue. What really causes increased triglyceride? Well, you can have unusual genetic problems, hypertriglyceridemia, and we've done videos on that. But what's the most common problem? Insulin resistance. Insulin resistance knocks that triglyceride right up. That's, in fact, one of the things that we look for. The first thing I look for on a cholesterol test, triglyceride over HDL, because when you've got insulin pouring out like you do with insulin resistance, that insulin stops the triglyceride burning. So you get more and more triglycerides. In addition, it burns up HDL. So again, that's just a little bit about remnant cholesterol, obesity, genetics, and most importantly, our old nemesis, insulin resistance. Thank you so much for your interest.
My name is Ford Brewer. I started off as an ER doc, became very frustrated with the fact that most things that bring people into the ER were preventable, like heart attack and stroke. I went to Johns Hopkins to get training and ended up running the program there in prevention. There I trained dozens of docs, and again, that was 3 decades ago. Since then, I've trained thousands of docs, and even more importantly, supervised those docs, and even most importantly, helped thousands of patients prevent things like heart attack and stroke. Waiting for the disease and hoping for a cure for this kind of devastation doesn't work. Come to Louisville November 8th and 9th. We have a boot camp type of environment for 2 days where you learn all the things that you didn't learn from your doc in terms of heart attack, stroke prevention, things like cardiovascular inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, things like insulin resistance, the number one cause of inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, how to stop it, how to manage it. You also get, you can get the labs there for that event, if you'd like, and get a complete evaluation. In addition, you get an arterial scan called a CIMT. To get the right one of those is fairly difficult. So I'm looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.